Welcome to Bible Tract Echoes. This program is the radio ministry of Bible Tracts Incorporated. Our mission is to take the Word of God to all the world. Our Bible teacher is the director of Bible Tracts, Pastor Mark Smith. Since 1938, Bible Tracts Incorporated has been publishing clear gospel tracts and supplying them to churches, missionaries, and individuals all over the world, and all at no charge. Information on how you can receive a free sample pack of our tracts will be given at the end of this broadcast. Now for our Bible study, here is our teacher, Pastor Mark Smith.
Hello, my friend. Welcome to the broadcast today. Thank you so much for allowing us to be a part of your day. And thank you for being one of those people that really want to grow in the grace and knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, right now, my Bible is sitting open to the book of Ruth, that little Old Testament book of Ruth. We're going to begin chapter 2 today. So if possible, right now, reach over, pick up your own copy of the Word of God, or turn on that electronic gadget of yours and get to the book of Ruth. I'll begin to read the opening three verses here in just a moment. I've got a gospel tract in my hand, and by that word tract, I'm referring to a short written presentation of God's plan of salvation. It's an evangelism tool that is very handy to use. It's handy because of its size, but it's clear in the gospel. And frankly, I have the smallest gospel tract that we produce here. I'll tell you more about it here in just a moment. Well, my friend, one of the prize stories which my wife and I like to tell each other and to other people is how our love relationship began. Now, for us, it was not love at first sight or even second sight. Our story was built over a few weeks and months. And, well, just to show you how romantic I am, it happened to be on Valentine's Day that I first told my future wife that I loved her. Well, our married life for these 43 years has been a continuing romance. How sad it is when so many marriages, even marriages between believers, end in some form of brokenness. But how does this happen? Well, maybe part, just part, of the answer is found here in the book of Ruth in chapter 2. Now, wait just a minute. I'm serious now. That God has left us a romance story is not an accident. God knew we were going to need an example of how to get it done right. So let's go to the Word of God and find out how a romance story gets done right. Get your Bible open to the book of Ruth and chapter 2. Now, I mentioned the gospel tract a moment ago. At the end of this program, my announcer is going to make known to you three ways by which you can communicate to us, giving us your name and mailing address. Would you please have pen and paper ready to do that? Here's why. I want to give you a free sample packet, a packet that contains one each of all of our English gospel tracts, those evangelism tools. Now, there's only one gospel message, but each of the 40 tracts in that sample packet comes at the same gospel message from a different vantage point. The one in my hand right now is the size of a credit card, and that's by design, and it's entitled Charge It with a Question Mark. Well, everybody knows what you do with a credit card. You can pay for things putting it to your account, and obviously you're supposed to eventually pay that bill. Well, on the back of this little Charge It card, it explains that our sin debt was charged to the account of Jesus Christ. On the back of a credit card-sized gospel tract, there's not a lot of room. You know it, and I know it, but there's plenty of room for us to give a clear gospel presentation using the Word of God. Faith cometh by hearing, hearing by the Word of God. You're going to find Bible verses here. Yes, the print is a little small, but friend, it's in a powerful little tool. I know of a lot of people who not only use this credit card size tract when they're out in restaurants and leaving it with their tip, but a whole lot of people, including yours truly, when they go buy gasoline, they'll put our card in, slide it in to purchase the gas. And when I pull my card out, this little charger card goes into that slot. And the next person who uses that gas pump has to pull this out. And lo and behold, we've put the gospel into their hand. Now, friend, let me send you this tract, please, as part of that sample packet. If you can't wait to the very end when our announcer gives our contact information, just go to our website. Our web address is BibleTractsInc.org, and you can sign up and get that free sample packet there. But if your Bible is open to the book of Ruth and chapter 2, verse 1 says this, "And Naomi had a kinsman of her husband's, a mighty man of wealth, of the family of Elimelech, and his name was Boaz. And Ruth the Moabitess said unto Naomi, Let me now go to the field and glean ears of corn after him in whose sight I shall find grace. And she, Naomi, said unto her, Go, my daughter. And she went and came and gleaned in the field after the reapers, and her hap," I love that word, "and her hap was delight on the part of the field belonging unto Boaz, who was of the kindred of Elimelech." Please stop right there. Now, friend, whenever we read our Bibles, please, please let us read first and foremost to find out the basic story or the basic point being made there. Every now and again, I find people who read a passage like this one and immediately do a mental pole vault over the obvious story so they can find some spiritual meaning. Please don't do that. Read the Bible as you would every other book. And yeah, I know the Bible is not just like every other book, but simply let the straightforward words mean what they naturally normally mean. Read the Bible in the context. Let the words say what they mean to whom they are spoken. The book of Ruth is a love story, and here in chapter 2 is where the two people who will fall in love are going to first meet. Now, please tell me, friend, don't you just love real stories like this? This is a standalone story about love and romance. God gave it to us. God left us this romance story for us to learn from. In so many marriages, no matter what the era or culture, far too many supposed romance stories begin and end on physical attraction. Well, God gives us an example of romance from which we can learn. Chapter 2 has four basic paragraphs, and here they are. Number 1, verses 1 through 7, which I've entitled The Work. The work. I could also label these verses by the word introduction, because here we are introduced to Boaz and to the love story. Number 2, paragraph number 2 is verses 8 through 13. My title is The Words. The Words. And here, for the very first time, words are going to be exchanged between the soon-to-be-married man and woman. I could also label verses 8 to 13 by using the word interest, because here Boaz is sure gonna take a genuine interest in Ruth. Then paragraph number 3, verses 14 to 16, is the welcome, or if you prefer, the invitation. Now, the invitation here has often been modernized by preachers by using this phrase. They entitle this, "Let's do lunch sometimes." When we get to that portion, you'll understand why they do that. The final paragraph, number 4, is verses 17 to 23. This I've entitled The Wisdom. The wisdom, or the word insight, could be used. And here is where the wise Naomi gives godly advice to Ruth concerning her budding relationship with Boaz. Well, come back here to verse 1 of chapter 2. Now, the opening three verses here give us the actors in the romance. These three opening verses give us three critical bits of information. Bit number 1 is the facts about Boaz. Information bit number 2 is the faithfulness of Ruth. And the third one is the field there in verse 3. Now, the facts and the faithfulness are critical here in this romance story. In verse 1, we learn about Boaz's relationship with the family, and we learn about his riches. We learn about his relationship and his riches. At the very outset in this romance story, God tells us two rather important things, two important lessons. Before a romance could begin, that is, one that leads to a God-honoring marriage, two critical factors need to be identified. One is this: Do the man and the woman have a right standing with the family? Do the man and the woman have a right standing with the family? Put more simply, it's this. Does the family approve? The next bit is this. Does the man have the financial ability to even consider getting married? Oh, my beloved friend, love is a wonderful thing, but you can't use it to buy groceries at Walmart. Love does not pay the rent on the apartment building, and love does not put gas in the gas tank of the car. Almost 20 years ago, a young man that was out of the church I was pastoring at the time, he was attending Bob Jones University. He had one extra semester he had to attend to graduate, and he called me and asked me my advice about getting married to a very fine godly girl before that final semester. Well, I asked him to ponder a verse from Proverbs. It was Proverbs 24:27. Proverbs 24:27, which says this, "Prepare thy work without, and make it fit for thyself in the field, and afterward build thine house." Well, I read the verse to the young man. The young man said, "Pastor, what in the world does that verse mean?" Well, I told him to memorize it, pray it through before the Lord for a few days, and then call me back. Well, about a week later, he calls me up and he tells me this. He says, "Pastor, preparing your fields is your work. That's where you earn your living. The house that you build is where you live and you have a family." Well, then I said to him, I said, "Well, what has the Lord been teaching you from the verse?" He said the Lord had taught him to first get a job and get himself financially able to ask the father of the bride for his daughter's hand in marriage. Well, he did, and about 6 months after graduation, a proposal was made, and that girl's dad was more than ready to give his daughter to this young man. Why? That man had a right relationship with his family and the girl's family, proven in real life. Plus, in those 6 months, he had been saving and squirreling away his money, getting himself a financial base upon which to get married and prove to the bride's dad he had the ability to pay the bills and care for the daughter. Oh, beloved, this romance story in Ruth really does have some practical advice for today, doesn't it? I wonder, are we teaching our young people in our local churches how real romance stories are to be happening? Do we ever actually use the Bible and the biblical illustrations? I love what Psalm 19 says. The testimonies of the Lord are sure. Here we have a testimony from the Lord of a romance, and it's a sure testimony. We can use it, bank on it, and say, if we will learn the lessons here, our romance story is going to end up different than the world is going to end up for the glory of God. If your romance story has been ruined because of sin, repent. God has grace when we openly, honestly repent of our brokenness in our lives. If you don't like your romance story the way it is, go to God and ask Him to help you change it for His glory.
Thank you for joining us today for Bible Tract Echoes. If you would like to receive a free sample packet of our tracts, you can contact us by calling 309-828-6888. Our mailing address is Bible Tracts, P.O. Box 188, Bloomington, Illinois, 61702. Again, our phone number is 309-828-6888. And our mailing address is P.O. Box 188, Bloomington, Illinois, 61702. You can also contact us through our website. Our web address is BibleTractsInc.org. Remember, the word tracts is spelled T-R-A-C-T-S. That address is BibleTractsInc.org. May the Lord richly bless you as you serve Him.